Hello friend, welcome back to my channel. If you are new to this channel, please subscribe my channel for such interesting videos. So why we sleep? Why sleep is necessary? There are some points which proves us why sleep is important. So some of them are, number one, not getting enough sleep can make you fatty. Did you ever thought that? Yes, sleep deprivation is linked to weight gain and is one of the biggest risk factor of obesity. According to researches, people who are sleep deprived are 55% more likely to be obese. Number two, for better hormonal functions. During sleep, our cortisol levels goes down as it is related to our stress too. And when we sleep, we feel relaxed after waking up. That's the reason. Improves insulin sensitivity. Definitely prevents you from type 2 diabetes or diabetes mellitus. Number 4. Increased testosterone level, which provides you more energy, which keeps you more energetic. Number 5. Improves your immune system function and give time your body to repair. Also decreases chances of being sick. Improves learning and reaction time. And this is the reason students should take a proper sleep. Number 7. This risk of mental health problems such as anxiety, depression, stress. Researchers also have shown that 90% of the patient of depression suffer from sleep apnea. Sleep, eat less as your hormonal regulation is perfect, which also decreases their cravings. Number 9. Improves your social behavior, as those who are sleep deprived loses their ability to properly recognize expression of others. Number 10. Relaxes your mind, as during sleep your heart rate and breathing rate decreases and your whole bodily muscles are relaxed. After knowing benefits of sleep, we should know what if we don't take enough or sound sleep. There are a lot of serious disadvantages of sleep deprivation. Some of them are, decreases your coordination ability, decreases ability to identify object by touch, decreases your concentration and brain ability to memorize, decreases short-term memory, you cannot remember something just instantly happened, like that, this is short-term memory, not that Gajni one. Induces gastric troubles such as gas or flatulence, affects your mood, memory and reaction time. If you are affected by sleep deprivation for a long time, it will induce hallucinations. Also, it will increase risk factor for hypertension, stroke and reproductive disorders. Sleep deprivation or not having a sound sleep can also cause decision fatigue in long term. Decision fatigue is a difficulty in making a good decision according to need and the situation, which is a vital function of our brain and human beings. You all were thinking that why sleep is so important and what happens when we sleep and what causes sleep deprivation harmful. So as we are human being and we are awake, we do something each second. We are busy all the time we are awake. So while we are awake, our cells work and for working they need energy. So when this energy is utilized by cells and as a result they release some byproducts, namely beta amyloid proteins, which is a major cause of Alzheimer's disease, a kind of protein. So now you are thinking, what happened to these toxins and how these are removed? So the answer is sleep. When we sleep, these toxins are removed from our body with the help of lymphatic vessels and a system called glymphatic system. This system removes waste while we sleep using cerebrospinal fluid, which is also called CSF, to flush away the toxic products present between cells. So here is the answer, what happens when we sleep. And the caffeine lovers were thinking, What makes coffee or tea makes us awake? So here is the answer. There are some chemicals which induces or increases the urge to sleep or makes us sleep. Example, adenosine and many more. And when we take caffeine in any form, tea or coffee and any other thing, they block the receptors which were inducing sleep. And we stay awake, but that collected toxins are not removed and generates symptoms of sleep deprivation in long term. Now, after discussing much more about what, why, and how sleep works, it's time to know some practical tips that will make your sleep a sound and quality one. Number one, use of black color. You were thinking how we can use black color in our bedroom or while sleeping. So you can use your bedroom furnishings like bedsheet, curtain, blankets black, or just sleep with complete lights off of your bedroom. Why we should use black color? Because it will increase secretion of sleep hormones like adenosine and melatonin, which will give you a good sleep. 2. Avoid exposure of unnatural light. Yes, this includes your tablet, PC or mobile phones, because they emit blue light, which in turn decreases secretion of sleep hormones or confuses them that it's day. And if you need a good sleep, keep your phones away with notifications turned off. 3. Good sleeping posture. You were thinking how sleeping posture, so we need to maintain a sleeping posture for sleep. No, it's not like that. Sometimes what happens is we are not fully relaxed, that what makes us discomfortable and we cannot fall asleep. So this sleeping posture can help you get a sound sleep. Generally what happens is when we lie on our bed, our back, especially lower back, does not completely relax us. So you can use pillow under your knees that makes your spine or whole back fully relaxed and help you to sleep better. A proper routine. Yes, you heard correct. A proper routine can affect or give you a good sleep. So for a perfect night routine, you can download a night routine sheet from the link given in the description. For more, you must have some of the followings. Number one, brushing after dinner. You should brush for your oral hygiene and maintaining your good health, especially cardiovascular health. Have a brisk walk. If you have time or you have a open nature near your home, you can have a brisk walk before you sleep. 10 to 15 minutes of reading after your dinner. This makes you feel calm and makes you feel better. Planning your next day. This is especially targeted to the working people or students, that will make them more focused and their brain to work accordingly. After routine, we have an interesting fifth point, that is exercise. Daily exercise of 20 to 25 minutes improves your sleep quality and depth. Number 6, breathing awareness. Before you sleep, if you are a lazy one like me, or you don't want to go for a walk, don't want to read something, you can just lie down on your bed and have some breathing awareness. You don't have to do anything, just aware of your breath. Keep your eyes closed, lights off, and just be aware of your breathing. Just feel from which nostril your breath is going in and going out. Feel the warmth when it's coming out and cold when it's going in. That's it. This makes you has a multiple benefits, including giving a sound sleep. For knowing more about breathing awareness, check the link given below in the description. Number 7, and most vital, especially for Indians, take meals 2 to 3 hours before sleep. If you sleep immediately after your dinner, it will result in gastric problems, as it will increase the gastric secretion products. So be aware. You should avoid taking alcohol or caffeine after your lunch itself, as they have a half-life of 6 to 8 hours and they can interfere your sleep cycle and affect your deep sleep. Number 9, oiling. Yes, oiling. Regular oiling to your feet can induce a good sleep and also prevent you from some problems like sciatica or back pains. Use lukewarm oil, preferably sesame oil or til oil. Apply gently to your whole legs, including your soles, and go for a sleep. Number 10, chanting. Mantra chanting before sleep can give you a magical sleep benefits. Preferably Om mantra or Gayatri mantra chanting will be perfect for a good sleep. Many people also ask about a perfect range of sleep. That includes maximum or minimum sleep that one has to take. So the answer is, you should not take sleep less than 7 hours and not more than 9 hours. Hope you like this video and find this interesting. So hit the like button and subscribe my channel for more videos like this. And if you... Thanks for watching.